Hi everybody, Mike Beer here with your Sunday DRF race of the day. It's at Aqueduct, race number 9, the Gravesend $100,000 purse for older sprinters. Before we get to the race though, just want to mention a new offer for DRF Bets members, new DRFF members. If you sign up for a new DRF Bets account today and use the promo code DOUBLE, we will double your first deposit up to $250. With DRF Bets, there's a lot of nice bonuses. If you become a new member, weekly cashback offers, access to free daily racing form, past performances, all kinds of good stuff there. You can get all the information at drf.com/bet. Now let's move on to this race of the day for Sunday. The Gravesend, it's a 6-furlong sprint for older horses. The field, as you can see right here, a field of six. And you'll notice that the number two in this race, Ferenz Fire, is a very, very heavy favorite on the morning line. He's pegged at 2-5, and he's just weighed the horse to beat in here. He is, Ferenz Fire is a legit grade one sprinter facing five rivals in this race who just, you know, aren't up to his level. If he shows up and runs, you know, one of his good races, he's just really, really hard for this field to beat. The interesting thing about this race is that five of the six horses that are entered in here are part of the original cast of the Fall Highweight when that race was carded for Thanksgiving weekend at Aqueduct. Unfortunately, that race never really got to run then. They canceled it. They rescheduled it. It was canceled again. They rescheduled it again. So Ferenz Fire, who was also a heavy morning line favorite for the original version of the Fall Highweight, he elected to scratch from that race. He went to Penn National on Thanksgiving weekend and ran in the Fabulous Strike down there. He faced a field that's, you know, sort of comparable to this one in that spot, and he just won for fun. He went off at 1-5 in that race. He got a good trip track in the pace, and he was just way better than those horses, and he won it ridden out with a 100 buyer speed figure. It's, you know, sort of feels like we're in for a similar situation. You don't just want to concede a race to a heavy favorite, but he's going to be very hard for this field to beat with his good form. Four of the other five horses, when they finally did run the Fall Highweight at Aqueduct 2 weeks ago, they ran in that race. You know, there were a couple of these horses that were in there. The three, No Distortion, the five, See This Quick. They were long shots that day. They were no factor in that race. They are going to be long shots again today. But two of the other horses, the six in this race, Happy Farm, and the four in this race, Wonderful Light, they ran 1-2 in that race. And they seem like they're probably the two main rivals for Ferenz Fire in this race. You know, if you want to take a shot against Ferenz Fire, you know, it seems like maybe you would think that a trip maybe could work against him. You know, along those lines, let's look at the pace projector right now for this race, because Timeform US is projecting that this race will be run in a manner that favors horses on or near the early lead. And they have Ferenz Fire on the early lead in this race. So it doesn't feel like Trip is going to compromise this horse, whether he's on the lead at the pace call or not. He is not the kind of horse who feels like that a trip is really going to work against him. He's got plenty of tactical speed. He'll either be on the lead or be right up close in this race. You know, as far as Wonderful Light and Happy Farm go, listen, I have no knocks on Happy Farm since Jason Service has claimed this horse. He's just been in really good form. He's won four races in a row while moving up in class. He's now a grade three winner by virtue of that Fall Highweight last time. And he ran really well in that race. He got the jump on Wonderful Light that day, had it positioned on that horse all the way around and held on to the finish. A nice effort from him. I thought Wonderful Light also ran well in that race. He wound up in behind horses. He had to try to run down Happy Farm Lady. Couldn't get him. I wouldn't be surprised at all if he was able to turn the tables on that rival today. But it's just hard to see either one of them really beating Ferenz Fire if he shows up. Down on the rail is the New York bred, a really good New York bred, a nice horse. He loves a fight. He's about to turn 6 years old. He's been in really good form for his current trainer. He's placed in a couple of New York bred stakes races recently, and he's, you know, an okay fit in this race. It's hard to see him beating a horse like Ferenz Fire. He could get a piece of it, though. You know, we'll see how he runs. He's a really, really cool horse and an easy horse to root for. Let's get to the top picks, though, because there's really not much to say about this race. Ferenz Fire, he's a top-class horse. He's weighed the horse to beat in here. He's going to be a very short price in this race, and I'm not going to try to beat him. I put him right on top in the race. I went 2-1, 4-6 in your Sunday DRF race of the day. It's the Gravesend. It's race number 9 at Aqueduct, and the approximate post time is 3:46 Eastern time. Good luck.